Welcome. Welcome into Fast Five, everybody. We're recording in the lobby. You may see and hear some sounds on the outside. Don't worry about it. It's all good.
Yeah, it's all good.
You used to Everything's be an umpire,
good.
Right?
Everything's good. I used to be an umpire. No. That's why I'm not an umpire anymore.
How did you call strike three, you're out?
Strike three, you're out.
That's how you did it?
No.
How did you do it?
None of your business. Let's
go. How did you do it? Again, strike three.
Question number one.
Will Raging Cajun forward Shawn Long play in the NBA?
I'm going to say yes, because that was a very general statement. I'll go ahead and qualify it, though. I don't think he's going to be drafted. And honestly, if you don't go in the top 30, maybe it's better you don't be drafted anyway. And I think that he may not play in his very first year. It's very possible he'll do a developmental thing. But eventually, at some point in time, yes, Shawn Long will play in the NBA.
The answer is absolutely yes. I mean, it might play out the way you just described.
No, it's going to play out the way
Elijah Millsap has played in the NBA. And Shawn Long is a better player than Elijah Millsap. No disrespect to a guy that spent some time with the Cajuns, but he's better. It might be a grind. It might be a journey to get there. It might not be, oh, first-round pick. He's playing in the NBA.
Yep.
Question number two.
Word is Peyton Manning isn't ready to retire and wants to come back and play somewhere. What do you think the driving factor is in his desire to keep playing?
Maybe just... I know he won the Super Bowl, but it wasn't like he played great. Like, his skills were kind of departing, and I feel like everybody thinks he has nothing left at all. And it's just probably that voice in his head saying, you still got it, but you still got it, Peyton Manning.
Yeah, that nice try. I just think he's not ready to stop playing, and I think it's as simple as that. I don't think it's, well, I wasn't as good as in the Super Bowl as some people thought I would be or I thought I would be. Sometimes that competitive spirit just doesn't die. I think he still wants to play because, ready? He still wants to play.
Wouldn't that be the same reason? You know, he just didn't like how he played. Doesn't it come from the same place?
No, I don't think necessarily so. I just think it's a desire to keep competing and compete and keep playing.
All right. It's a distractive day here on Fast Five. We got noises all over the building.
Look, Romero's going to walk out in a second. It's no big deal. Let's go. What's number three?
Let's rock and
roll. Give me number three.
Question number three.
Where do you think a 40-year-old Manning will play next year?
I think the Los Angeles Rams would love to have him because they're going back to Los Angeles. Big media market. He comes in, still has the competitive spirit. Pub. There you go.
I think it's going to be a rough ending to Peyton Manning's career if he plays next year, because it's going to probably be the Cleveland Browns.
Oh, my.
Yeah, Jimmy Haslam, the owner, big Tennessee guy.
Let's pray for him now.
Friends with Peyton Manning.
Pray
and maybe
Peyton.
It's like, Peyton, we want you to be in the front office someday here, so come play for us for a year. We'll throw you this favor. It won't look good. I could see it happen.
Ugh.
Question number four.
Steph Curry is playing at a level that makes him must-see TV. Who is another American athlete in professional sports that is currently must-see TV?
Right now, I don't think there is one. I think, you know, in baseball, it comes in spurts. Steven Strasburg, when he first started pitching, it was kind of must-see TV for a little while. That went away. There's just not that guy currently in golf. I mean, there's not a guy like Tiger was. I don't think Cam Newton is there right now in the NFL. I think Steph Curry currently is the only guy, truly, in America that's must-see TV.
Yeah, I have a tendency to agree with that. The only guy that's coming to mind for me is Mike Trout of the California Angels. I think the guy's just such a complete baseball player but I don't think he's on Curry's level. That's just the name that came to my mind. If I was forced to pick somebody out of anybody, it would be Trout, but I agree with you. Nobody's in Curry's league.
Question number five.
Everyone has a guilty pleasure TV show that they know isn't all that great, but love it anyway. What's your TV viewing guilty pleasure?
I'm happy to report it is not Keeping Up with the Kardashians. I am happy to report it's not American Horror Story. I am happy to... Yeah, I've started watching it again. I got away from Survivor for about 3 years, and I've started watching
it again. Is that what that was? That was supposed to be the Survivor theme?
Yeah.
No. All right, so my guilty pleasure is kind of like the trashy version of Survivor, the challenge on MTV where they bring back like these kind of sad former reality stars and they kind of have a Survivor-esque contest. And
you watch that?
I can't get enough of it. It's really bad, man. Oh, it's really bad. I have problems, but you already knew this.
Yeah.
All right, give us one, before we go, give us one strike three, you're out.
Strike three, you're out.
Oh,
that's it for Fast Five for this week. That's
Scott. And again, Faka!
Maybe you get a strike three next week. Stay tuned.
Hodo, hey, do, hodo, hey, do. What?